Hi, good morning. The first video that I filmed and posted on YouTube featured a wind turbine made with plastic coat hangers and styrofoam. I think the bonding element was scotch tape. Today I will give you a few details. To make the coat hanger windmill, coat hanger wind turbine, also known as the hangaround windmill or the hangaround wind turbine, I started with a coat hanger and I traced the inside contour of the coat hanger on a piece of styrofoam. You will find flat styrofoam that you can recycle. I'll do it with a marker right now, because the marker is more visible. And if I was going to make a wind turbine out of it, I will do it with a pencil, because I don't want residue from the marker to show up irregularly, depending on what the cut happens to be. So you will go around tracing a few, and if you want to be efficient, you'll try to take advantage of the line, the longest line that's already there. So I will start this one right here. In one cut. The one cut will be used for two pieces. The one long cut that they both share. So basically, something like that. You know what's going on here. So that's the way it will start. Then I will cut it and I'll show you how I did that as well. To cut, I use a brand new razor blade. I put a board below. Then I follow the line. Usually I try to remove as much as the line as possible, but this time I just cut. And it cuts easily if your razor blade is nice and sharp. Any precision that you need happens in the curves. I have one piece here and I can remove the extra part as well. Okay. Basically that's all there is to this operation. Once you cut the pieces, the next step is to make them fit into the coat hangers. First I center it. I want to make sure it's being filmed. Squeeze in one corner, squeeze in the other corner. This one is not perfect, so maybe if I rotate it, I'll see a better fit. There we go. One piece seems to be too long, and one piece seems to be too perfect. Okay, so we'll cut the extra from this corner. Here we go. Simple as that. Alright, now it goes in. It's all in, nice and neat. And to make sure it doesn't come out, take some clear shiny tape, a type that's very strong, and we buckle up the corners. One, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, that tip is much stronger than the styrofoam, so I don't worry about it. Okay. Let it sit here. 1, 2, 3. Now I will also reinforce it or wrap it up or secure it, no matter how you want to say it, towards the middle. 1, 2. I guess 2 layers is plenty. Make sure it makes good contact. And I'll do that once more on this side. Right there. 1, 2, 3. And that can take some wind. Now, to turn, use this for turbine, we find a bicycle wheel. And we find an angle to hang them, and I'll show you how to do that as well. The next thing you do, you find a bicycle wheel and you count the number of spokes it has. The number of spokes is the same as the number of spaces between the spokes. And you take your coat hanger filled with styrofoam and you place it at an angle that's convenient to make the windmill rotate. And once you find that angle, you just insert it in. It can take a little stretching, but the reason why you want to count the number of spokes first is because you will know exactly how many blades you can install that are equidistant to each other. So right now I just installed a blade, but if I give you a profile look, that thing is installed straight up. This thing will not make the wheel rotate, so I have to take it out and find a better angle. This angle looks better. I place it here. Let me put it all the way down here. Lift this a little bit. Make it snap. Yeah, I have a little angle there, but I'm still not pleased with it, so I'll try this one here. Now I have an angle. You can see the coat hanger moving away from the frame. Here, it's touching the frame, it's touching the rim. Here, it's about an inch away from it. I can slide my hand behind, between it and the rim. That gives me an angle. You want more of an angle? Find another way to insert it. But the hook itself is resting on the rim. So I can put it right here, or I can pass it behind the rim and push everything down. This is a more stable setup. As you can see this thing, I can even pick the wheel up with it, I think. Here we go. I didn't use anything, just pure pressure and correct location. To make sure it doesn't go anywhere, I will take a piece of wire and wrap this area here of the coat hanger in a wire and tie it up to this spoke. That will prevent it from lifting and taking off. But this almost prevents it from lifting, but a little wire would be the easy way to go about it. You could also apply heat and bend the hook itself under the rim, but I don't think that's necessary. Now that you have counted the number of spokes or spaces you have between the spokes, you install as many blades as you can get away with that will be equidistant to each other. Just lift the wheel, tighten the axle on one end, and the wind will make it spin. So that's the end of the story about the hangaround wheel mill.